Today I will prepare a simple but tasty sourdough semolina bread. My name is Stefano, welcome to my channel. If you're new and you're interested, click like and consider subscribing. It will be sincerely appreciated. But let's start with the recipe. Do an autolysis by combining 690 grams De Cecco remilled semolina and 560 grams water. Mix first with a spoon and then by hand. To discover that if in one hand semolina absorb much more water than normal flour, on the other hand is low in gluten, and this will result in a dry but not formed dough. Let it in autolysis for about 2 hours and let's see if the situation improves. After 2 hours, as you can see, the dough is still not formed but improved. Then evacuate the mess on a working table, spread slightly, trying not to break the gluten mesh. Pour in 140 grams of sourdough starter, previously fed 3 times using the same semolina flour, and apply a truffle fold because now it's time to introduce 16 grams of salt. Fold again in 3, then begin a series of slap and fold until the dough is able to take no more, without damaging the gluten. Do not overdo it. Return to the bowl, cover with plastic wrap and let it rest at room temperature for 30 minutes. Evacuate again a working table and apply a series of coil folds on each side. As mentioned before, semolina has a low gluten content, which has a characteristic of being short and tenacious. So while doing the coil fold, try to keep that on mind. Place it back in the covered bowl and leave to rest for 30 minutes. At this point, check if the dough has improved. In my case, it still needs to be strengthened, so I continue with another series of coil folds. Rest cover for 30 minutes, after that let's see if the structure of the dough will hold up a lamination. Wet the surface of the working table with your hands, place the mass and spread it out, trying to form an homogeneous rectangle, as thin as possible without breaking it. The dough itself will tell you when to stop. Fold in 3 and then wrap it around itself. All these steps of slap and fold, coil folds and lamination are used to form the gluten necessary to give structure to our bread. Let it rest covered with plastic wrap for 1 to 2 hours, or until double in size. Then so we don't introduce any more flour into the situation, I like to work this dough on lightly wet countertop with lightly wet hands for good measure. Stretch it slightly and divide into 2. Shape the dough with your favorite method, always working with wet hands and surface. Now place the loaf in a proofing basket, sprinkling with some semolina, and try to close the open parts of the loaf. Place the bread in a sealed bag and let it rise. Here you can root 2 ways, at room temperature for 2 hours or, if you want to achieve even a better taste, in the refrigerator overnight, as in my case. So the next day, remove the bread from the fridge, turn it upside down on parchment paper and bake in a preheated oven at 240 degrees Celsius for something between 30 to 40 minutes or until golden brown. In addition to being very tasty, the semolina bread is easy to digest and suitable for those suffering from slightly gluten intolerances. It is high in protein, rich in fiber, mineral elements, vitamins and antioxidants. Semola is obtained from the grinding of durum wheat, which will give 3 different types of flour: wholemeal semolina, semolina and remilled semolina. Allow to cool for 1 hour before slicing and uncovering a very soft and tasty golden crumb and a crunchy and crumbly crust. And that's all for today's video. If you enjoyed, click like, consider subscribing, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode.